Welcome to Lenovo Unboxed. I'm Gavin, and I'm here, as always, with Kevin Beck.
Gavin, how you doing?
Good. I'm doing great. Listen, guys, we've got a big, big day for you today on Lenovo Unboxed. Yep. It's a product we've talked about for months, and we're excited to share with you the IdeaPad Yoga.
Yep.
It's a new kind of product. We've unboxed many tablets, many laptops
in the past.
And today we have something that we hope will blow your mind and take you into the future.
Yeah. We've got a little twist on our classic unboxing. I do not have my patented or trademark box cutter.
That's right.
Because today we're doing an unsleeving. We actually got one of these in our hands, and it was going to be quite a bit more time before we could actually get one in the box. So we decided to go ahead and do the unsleeving. So the first thing...
It's still early days, and it is a very attractive sleeve made from, we've been saying, Corinthian pleather, but that's not really... but it is an accessory that'll be available that you can get to go along with your yoga.
Yeah. All kidding aside, it does have like a fairly cool looking, but also useful texture that keeps it from slipping. Right. There's actually a kind of raised surface here, so it gives it a really good feel.
Useful in the sense that you're not going to slip. Your hands won't slip off it.
So we'll show one more thing about this. So we're going to leave it on the pedestal here. So this is, what do we got, two colors, Gav?
Yeah, there's clementine orange pictured here, and silver gray is the other.
Give you my best Vanna white there.
Thank you.
The clementine orange.
And you will find that the color availability is different by country, so check to see what's available where you live. This, as we said, it's early days. This is the one that we could find here at work, and we wanted to show off to you as soon as we could. So.
Okay, so we've opened it, and I'm going to go past my lock screen here to our start screen. You will not have failed to notice that I use my fingers to do that.
10-finger touch capability, is that right?
10-finger touch laptop. So I think if I were looking at buying this, the most important thing to me is how does it function as a laptop to start with, right? So my opinion, we've got full bells and whistles.
Okay.
16.9 millimeters, under 17 millimeter, Ultrabook, 13.3-inch screen, 8 gigs of RAM, up to 256 gig SSD, and up to Core i7 processor. So as a laptop, as an Ultrabook, fabulous unit.
All right, so no remaining vestige of the days of the netbook when a few years ago when people were, you wanted something thin and light and you were willing to give up some power. Yep. So this thing's fully powered.
All right, so nice big glass, smooth. Touchpad here.
Okay.
I won't like completely go around the horn, but we've got HDMI, we've got USB 2.0, we've got USB 3.0, we've got volume, we've got a power switch, and we've got your combo headphone microphone jack.
Okay.
So as a laptop, fully covered in the spec department, we did say 10-finger touch, right?
Yeah, 10 fingers, which is, if you guys saw our A720, the huge all-in-one that we had, that was the first product I'd seen with the 10-finger touch. It's not just pinch and zoom. You're actually able to do way more complicated things involving the touchscreen. And, Kevin, you may also want to talk about the interface on this thing, right?
Yeah. We've got, with the new operating system. Can we say that? Can we say Windows 8?
You say it. It's the beautiful new Windows 8 interface.
Windows 8 operating system.
And that's a big part of what's sort of hurtling us into the future.
Right. So you've got a number of ways to interact with this, as I think you've seen. You can switch between open applications here by scrolling in from the side. And then over here I've got some of my charms that get me back to the start menu. And these
both charms.
Yes. These both, these gestures work with the touchpad as well. Right. You just have to do it right. There we go. And then I believe I can, if I do the gesture right, I can pull in from the side there.
Nice.
You know, I can start here and finish there. So I've got a lot of different ways to interact with that, as well as, sort of traditional mouse control.
And so it's worth noting that when Windows 8 is out, and it's very soon after you see this video, or it's already out, you'll be able to access your traditional desktop apps on your laptop, and then also go to the Windows Store, right?
Just tap that right there, and I'm to a traditional desktop, and as you say, Windows Store for all of your application needs.
Great. And one more note on the display. This is an IPS display, is that right?
Yes, 1600 by 900 IPS display. So I don't know if we can capture this on our camera here. Let me go back to the start screen mode so we have a kind of bunch of different colors. But if we can get that without too much glare, I think most of you know what the benefits of IPS are. But in terms of the color fall off and the dimness of the screen as you rotate around, it's up to about 170 degrees. You get really good color fidelity and lack of washout, which is going to become extremely important when we start showing the true value of the Yoga.
That's right. And just, before we started shooting today, we were looking at it from the most acute angles, and it still looked just beautiful, very bright, very colorful. So, and let's cut to the chase for people, Kevin, because again, this is not just a laptop. This is something so much more. And we've been referring to it as a multi-mode PC or a multi-mode device.
Right.
And there are four modes that we've talked about. Kevin, show the guys. I'm going to go ahead and get this beautiful sleeve out of the way here.
Not to delay it any further, but just to point, to kind of get to the why of why we did this, is because there are some people who are happy with only a phone, right? There are some people who are happy with only a PC. Some people who are happy with only a tablet, right? But there are things that tablets are good at, consumption. There are things that laptops are good at, production.
Creation.
And so instead of carrying two devices with their total aggregate weight being, in most cases, over 3.4 pounds, we've got a 3.4 pound package here that in traditional laptop fashion, and this may be difficult for you guys to see, but once you go up to 180 degrees here, this top hinge, this top action of the hinge is the only thing that's being actuated. But as I pick this up and spin this around, you can see that the bottom half of the hinge unlatches, and I can spin this completely all the way around, and voila,
the screen rotated.
And the screen image just rotated. I have myself a fully functional tablet.
Right? Yes, you do.
So pick this up. It works in exactly the same way, full desktop, swipe in from the side, change or cycle between my apps, go back to my start menu.
And again, traditional desktop apps or ones that you might go to the Windows Store and download.
Yeah, absolutely. So full fidelity tablet in that respect. But as our team was exploring how we think people might actually use this, they came up with a couple of interesting use cases or modes for it. So the first one being obviously the traditional laptop mode.
Right.
Right. I don't think that needs much explanation.
Second being your tablet.
Yeah, being full on tablet mode. But there are cases when, let's say, you want to watch movies or read an ebook or Skype or something like that. So especially in a plane seat, this makes absolute sense to use it like this, right? Because you're no longer got your screen sticking up from the other side.
And we're calling this one stand mode, is that right?
Right, that is the stand mode. So, I mean, any use, certainly you could use it like this on your desk or your plane seat.
Sure, I DJ a lot at home.
Yeah.
I would DJ with this, maybe Skyping as well, certainly.
Well, and the key thing about this is not just the physical utility of the shape getting the screen closer to you, right? I don't think you'd be doing a lot of long-term typing on the screen with this, but it actually gets the touchscreen closer so that for the touch interface, if you need to fast forward, rewind, or you're listening to music and browsing through things, you've still got the full utility of this, right? And the screen is closer. You're not reaching over the keyboard to get to it.
Gotcha. Okay.
Right? And then just kind of, what I would call like a quick and dirty mode is if you just need to sit the thing around and you want to show somebody a quick movie or something like that, or you want to sit it on the counter in the kitchen and look at a recipe, it also works equally well in this kind of tented mode, we're calling it.
Yeah, tent mode to me is the one. This is the eye-popper when I first saw yoga in January. This one kind of blew my mind because, again, we've got these hinges, which I don't know if we fully exploited the fact that these are Lenovo patented hinges.
Oh, yeah, this is...
And once you go past 180 degrees and the keyboard is disabled and you go into this tablet mode, then it becomes a completely different beast, and that's when my imagination kind of kicks in here. So this, to me, is my sort of favorite mode out of the four.
Yeah, and I definitely wanted to touch on that we certainly thought about the fact that the keys have no business being active when it is tilted past 180 degrees, because when you're carrying around it as a tablet, the last thing you want, let me get it back over here last thing you want is, your fingers to be pressing things over here on the back, and like randomly launching things. So it completely turns off the keyboard. If you want to hand me the sleeve real quick, that's sort of the second use case that for people who do end up wanting to use it more often than not. In tablet mode, they also made the width and sort of the grippiness of the case such that it can also be used when it is in tablet mode.
Right.
So if that's your primary use case.
Sorry to interrupt you. Yeah. When we first talked about yoga, some of our Facebook fans had a lot of questions about the keyboard as well, and it had to do with so you disable the keyboard when you bend it around, but wouldn't you still scratch up the keyboard or mess it up? And what have we done here design-wise, Kevin, that protects the keyboard?
So it will be difficult to see, but the keys are actually recessed below the level of the palm rest.
Okay.
So
slightly sunken in.
Right. When it is flipped all the way around, is what I'm trying to say, and you lay it down, you're actually not pressing the keys. You are resting it on this bezel, which has a slight non-skid, slightly rubberized type of surface.
Okay.
So it keeps it from sliding around so much. and you're not pressing the keys. So there's actually a lot of thought that went into the design to make sure that you aren't causing long-term wear and tear.
Okay.
You know, and we, as with all of our products, do, you know, extensive testing for the use cases that we think real users are going to put it through. So there's a full testing cycle of 25,000 open and close cycles on these hinges to make sure that...
very similar to our ThinkPads.
Right.
I know we
make sure that it's actually going to stay where you put it.
Okay.
Yep.
I understand there's also a special finish on the keyboard as well that keeps it from getting scratched up. And
correct.
So, yeah,
correct.
Good to know.
Absolutely.
What have we not talked about with Yoga? I mean, I got to be honest, we were excited enough about this that I didn't prepare like I usually did. I was just like, let's get the thing out here. What have we missed?
No, I think we've hit all the key points because...
How about battery life? What's the battery life going to be like on Yoga?
8 hours.
Okay.
8 hours. So. Good. In every respect, if you were to only buy this as an ultrabook, I think it is a completely competitively spec'd ultrabook in that respect, in terms of what you're getting.
Yeah.
But then, of course, we're also adding this secondary mode, so you get full touchscreen capabilities, full tablet capabilities, and then the tent and the stand. So just trying to take the utility of two different devices, put them into one, and not make a compromise. You're not giving up anything from a laptop side. You're not really giving anything up from a tablet side, perhaps other than this, you know, obviously being a little bit heavier as an entire unit than just a standalone tablet. But if what you're really looking at is truly needing to have a tablet for the way that you want to interact with your media and your sort of digital life, you know, this works for me.
So one device that really does the work of two.
To rule them all.
Yes. In four different modes, right? So one device... Yeah. Doing the work of two in four modes.
Yep.
And so we've been posing the question, have you flipped for Yoga?
Yeah.
And if you hadn't already, we hope that this unboxing helps you understand what Yoga is, what it does, and we hope that you will flip for Yoga. Kevin, thanks for being with us today.
Thank you, Gavin. Enjoyed it.
All right.